Fala, galerinha do inglês, tudo bem com vocês? Sou eu mesma, a teacher Priscila. Hoje, na quinta série do Conexão Escola da EAGEM, Língua Inglesa, nós vamos estudar um pouquinho sobre a família e fazer algumas interpretações de texto. Então, vamos ao nosso textinho de hoje. Repare bem na pronúncia e depois vamos fazer os exercícios. Everybody has an origin. We came from a country, a state, a city, a family. Each family have their particularities, culture, differences in upbringing children, and so on. We all have family members that we love, some that lives far away from us, some that we don't like very much, but they still being our family. For this so important topic that is part of everyone's life, let's learn how we can talk about our family in English. First of all, your father and your mother, you call them parents. Your family members, the other people from your family, you call them relatives. In English, there's a division for your family made by the members that you are connected directly and the other ones. Your father, mother, and siblings, you say they are your immediate family. All of your family members from your father and mother's families, you can say that they are your extended family. In English, unlike in Portuguese, we don't say brothers for boy and girl. We say brothers for boys and sister for girl. If you have brothers and sisters, so you must call them siblings. If you have a son or daughter, they are your child, and your husband or wife is your spouse. But we know that a family isn't made just with bonds of blood, because there are some members who became part of it after some change, as when someone got married, or deaf, or divorced. With these changes, we face with a new family member. In these cases, we say that we have a step family. Some children are born into a step family when they are adopted, for example. Agora a gente tem aqui uma lista dos membros da família. Eu vou falar em inglês e você leia a tradução em português. Parents, child, children, son, daughter, brother, sister, grandfather, grandmother, grandson, granddaughter, grandchild, great-grandfather, great-grandmother, great-grandparents, uncle, aunt, cousin, nephew, niece, boyfriend, girlfriend, fiancé, bride, groom. Bride and groom, galera, apenas no dia do casamento, ok? Wife, husband, spouse, father-in-law, mother-in-law, parents-in-law, son-in-law, daughter-in-law, brother-in-law, sister-in-law, godfather, godmother, godson, goddaughter, godchild. E alguns exemplos de frases relativas à composição da família. Eu vou ler em inglês e você lê a resposta silenciosamente da tradução em português. I have one child. I love my parents. I have four siblings. I live with my grandparents. She didn't knew her great parents. He never has a godchild. I went out last night with my sister-in-law. Vamos para os exercícios? O que que o texto fala sobre as nossas origens? Qual o significado da palavra upbringing? Apresente os dois exemplos que o texto nos mostra ao falar sobre a diversidade de afetos e tipos na nossa família. O que é a extended family? Qual é a palavra em inglês usada para falar sobre irmãos e irmãs sem distinção de gênero? Segundo o texto, o que ocorre quando mudanças na família acontecem? O que é uma stepfamily? Faça a tradução completa do texto. Pratique seu speaking pronunciando os membros da família no vocabulário desse vídeo. Espero que vocês tenham gostado do texto e dos exercícios. Kisses, bye bye!